Thomas-wilson Ikubese, the presidential aspirant, National Conscience Party.
Yes, sir. The current situation in Nigeria calls.
Most for me, I believe in a long-lasting approach to getting lasting solutions to problems. And the major problem we have had over time is that we have leaders who are not projectile in their thinking. We have refineries. How many of them are working? What we need to do, first of all, is to make sure our refineries are working. If we have refineries that are not working, we keep going round in cycles. It is an insult that Nigeria is the only member of OPEC that still exports its crude to be refined and then imported as finished product back to the country. So what I had expected this government to do, and which is what we are going to do when we get in 2019, is to see that we ensure that our refineries work. These things can work. Until we have a government that is truly ready to make the refineries work, we keep going round in cycle. This problem has been there for years, for ages. It's because of sabotage, it's because the government is not genuinely committed to making it work. So the lasting solution to it is to see that the refineries work. The other thing that is important is that you liberalize the market. The government should not fix prices for people. The government has no business doing subsidy, which we have said they are still coming back to do now. We are told that the subsidy has been removed, but it's still there at the end of the day because they are still supplementing for the shortfalls that has to do with those who are importing the fuel. So liberalize the market. NNPC has no business importing fuel. NNPC should be an importer of last resort. But when you make NNPC the major importer, then those who have the business of doing business to make profit, they go to sleep. So let NNPC be involved in regulation of the market. Encourage the importers to import and let them fix their price. The price doesn't have to be the same. Why must we say that petroleum should be the same in the north compared to the south? The cost of petroleum per liter in Delta State doesn't have to be the same in Sokoto State. So there should be nothing like fixation of price. This is business. Let the marketers import, let them do their business, let them make their profit. Those who will jack it up, those who jack their down, we balance it. At the end of the day, the system will check itself and everybody will be happy.
Still
blame. The government has a responsibility of making our citizens comfortable. Like you have said, every December this happens. What I have expected to see is the government calling stakeholders meeting every October ending. We don't want fuel scarcity to occur in December. It must not happen. So is there any issue that we should resolve before it gets to December? It should be an annual thing. You just anticipate that there could be, it happens every December, and then by January we have increment. We don't want that to happen. So every October ending, we have stakeholders meeting in the petroleum sector. Do we have any outstanding debt we are owing you? We pay them. Do we have any issue? We resolve them. So you don't wait for the system to break down before you start running up and down. I saw the GMD of NNPC going to filling stations locking. That's not his job. We should be able to think outside of the box, anticipating that this thing could happen and that will prevent it from happening before it ever happens at all. The government has no business fixing price, like I have said. You liberalize the market. Let the market, the forces of demand. If you have abundance of products, you cannot hoard. You can only hoard where you have scarcity. So number one thing, there should be deliberate attempt to making the refineries work. It's not rocket science. Must all the trucks go to Apapa to load? Why can't we load from other parts of the country? Why can't we have seaports that function and then liberalize the system? Each time I pass through on Onitsha Bridge, I weep. That is a beautiful spot that we can have a functional port that could serve the east. Why must everything be concentrated in a particular part? So these are things that is important for us to make work. We have a kind of fire brigade approach. That's our leaders are not ready to make the system work for whatever reason. I believe they know what to do. But in 2019, the change will come. Enough of recycling the same people with the same old ideas that has not helped us over time. Government is not rocket science. We can make this nation work. And like I did say, within 6 months, Nigeria will be like a nation out of the world. It's Ikubese was not prepared for governance. A government that takes 6 months to constitute its cabinet is certainly not prepared for governance. A government that will give two major ministries to one person in areas that are not related to his discipline is not prepared for governance. So it's one thing to feast on propaganda. The people were tired in 2015. They just wanted a breakaway from the PDP. So any option was an option. But now we can see that the option we have chosen is maybe even worse than where we were coming from. So talking about the NCP, we all know the antecedent of Chief Ganifa Wahimi, what he stood for in his lifetime, and that is what we are still pursuing at the moment. It's a party that believes in a system that works. We believe that government should be a place for service and not for the accumulation of wealth. A system where members of your cabinet are indicted of corruption and it took you 6 months to take an action. You know, so what we have is a government that is dragging its feet. We have a government that is not ready to step on toes because certain forces, certain powers were responsible in bringing you to power. So you have to tread gently and favor them rather than favor the people. And that's why we are saying that in 2019, the people themselves should take dominance of governing. The people themselves should own the government, not a few people that will begin to dictate who does what and who does not do what. So we cannot compare the promises of the APC with the promises that the NCP is giving through my candidacy in 2019. This is real, this is genuine, and we are going all out to make sure that Nigeria becomes a workable nation. So hope to Nigerians is do not give up. Do not trade your voter's card. Please go and get your voter's card. Genuine change is coming in 2019. Do not take a copper, do not take thousands from people to cast your ballot. If you do that, you are selling your future, you are selling your destiny, and all of us will suffer for it. So let's get ready, 2019. The people themselves, we are going to the ballot, we are going to change the status quo. We cannot keep recycling the same set of old brigade and expect a different result. The difference is that let's go out and begin to conscientize the people. Let's go out and begin to tell the people that Nigeria has everything that it takes to be the greatest black nation on earth. This is one nation where we have human and natural resources scattered everywhere. Our problem has been the problem of leadership. And in 2019, the NCP, through my candidacy, is going to change that problem and make Nigeria a functional place. Nigerians have no business traveling out of this country. If you are traveling out of Nigeria, you are going there for holiday, you are going there for fun, not to go and hustle because you want to make money. We have everything. We will make the system work. Like I said, within 6 months, we have 24-hour power supply. We've done all those analyses. Nigeria will work. There will be job. Everything will go the way it should go because if we are ready to make it happen, then it will happen. And in 2019, together,